So, you found us, Detective. Well, I see no reason to hide anymore. I've been behind everything. The children helped me spread panic with the legend of the leprechauns. But now, with the stakes this high, I can't let anyone get in my way. Casey, please use your toy to hypnotize Mr. Detective.
I'm sorry, Detective, but we're out of options.
Casey. He's done nothing wrong. Save him, and I'll confess everything. Here's the truth, Detective. My pupils found the gold of the leprechauns. We planned to spend it on repairing the orphanage to make it a better place to live. As you saw, it's in terrible condition. But the mayor used threats and blackmail to take the gold for himself, leaving the orphanage in ruin. People believed in the legend of the leprechauns. So Casey and I used that to return the stolen gold. Read this letter and you'll see that I'm telling the truth. I promise we will send all the children back home, but go to the mayor's mansion before you arrest us. You'll find the evidence and understand our decision.
Miss O'Farrell was behind the entire plot alongside Casey, her former pupil. She said that her children found the gold of the leprechauns, but Mayor Campbell took it away, leaving the orphanage in poverty. Miss O'Farrell and the orphans worked together to bring the legend of the leprechauns to life and get the gold back. According to their plan, the mayor would return the stolen treasure to the lighthouse in exchange for the missing children. Now that the children are safe, I must go to the mayor to learn the truth and recover the gold for the children.
Detective, what are you doing in my house? Are you accusing me? The gold is mine, and nobody will take it from me.
Thank you.
Detective, I didn't take the gold from the orphanage out of greed. I did it because I'm sick, and I need this money for the treatment. My savings were not enough. I can't let you or anyone else stop me.
Mayor Campbell stole the gold from Miss O'Farrell's orphans. The mayor intended to spend the gold on his treatment, leaving the orphans in poverty. He was bankrupt and saw an opportunity to get the money another way. But Miss O'Farrell didn't back down. She decided to get back what had been stolen. And so the leprechauns arrived in Dublin and hypnotized the children of wealthy families. But did the ends justify the means? The gold was returned to the orphans, and the citizens of Dublin forgave Miss O'Farrell. All the missing children returned home safe and unharmed. The orphanage was rebuilt anew. Manus Clark gave Casey Gallagher a chance to return to work. They even donated some toys to the new orphanage. Mayor Campbell was arrested for blackmail and theft, but Miss O'Farrell eventually forgave him and helped him pay for medical care. My investigation was a success. The holiday celebrations went on, and the leprechauns remained a legend.